Hi, you're watching Current Issues. My name is Vineet Malhotra. One out of every four crimes in the country takes place in New Delhi. Rape, abduction, kidnapping are some of the areas where crime in Delhi is rearing its head. And this is not the end of the list. Crimes against women, crimes against children, complaints against police and economic offences have all risen since 2014. Post December 16, 2012, it was projected that the state of sorry affairs in the capital of our country will be different. But it was not meant to be. Old governments were routed out and new administrations with promises of prosperity and safety were voted in. But nothing seems to change here. What will it take to turn it into a place where a decent society can be nurtured? Let's find out after listening in to this report.
Crime against children. Crime against women. Crime against senior citizens. Complaints against police. Economic offences. Kidnapping and abductions. This all you can find very easily in India's capital, Delhi. A quarter of total crimes in Indian cities last year took place in the country's capital. This is more than the next six cities put together. According to figures released on Tuesday by the National Crime Records Bureau, 1,73,947 crimes were reported in Delhi in 2015, which is 25.7% of the total crime in India's largest cities. The country has 53 mega cities. That is, cities with a population of over 10 lakh. These crimes in Delhi last year include 570 murders, 770 attempts to commit murder, 7,730 kidnappings, and 2,199 cases of rape. Delhi contributed to 6.1% of the overall violent crimes in India. Delhi easily topped the list and left its closest competitor. Mumbai contributed to about 6.4% of the total crime in megacities, closely followed by Bengaluru. Other cities with a large volume of crime include Jaipur, Kolkata, Indore, Hyderabad, Patna, Ahmedabad and Pune. Data provided by the National Crime Records Bureau for 2014 and 2015 and the Delhi Police for the same year show the crime graph climbing with each passing year. But crimes that tormented a large number of people in the city were rising incidents of theft, robbery and kidnapping. Delhi again easily recorded the most number of violent crimes among the union territories and ahead of many other states as well. Team News World India.
So the national capital is reeling under a wave of crime, and year on and year in, this wave does not seem to halt. Every year, the numbers, the statistics, they always startle the reader as well as those people who are living in this city. Let's get into this debate by welcoming our guest. With me in the studio is Sharad Kohli. Sharad is a socialite as well as a business analyst. Sharad, thank you so much for joining us in the studio. We have with us Mr. T.R. Kakkar, who is the former Delhi Police Commissioner. Sir, thank you so much for joining us. Aishwarya Bharti, lawyer for the Supreme Court, will also be giving her valuable inputs on this particular topic. But Sharad Kohli, let's start with you. Is it the liberal registration of cases which has probably, you know, shot up this statistic? Or do you really think, you know, that Delhi is never going to cease to become the crime capital of this nation?
See, we need to look at two aspects of this startling statistics relating to Delhi. I mean, we seem to be living in a crime capital, and being country's capital and being a crime capital is a matter of shame. It is a matter of embarrassment for the citizens of Delhi to be staying in a place, not just risking their lives, properties, whatever, but also suffering from the reputation issue. Where you're living at such a place. Delhi is a city of migrants. I mean, it is brushing shoulders with Uttar Pradesh. It is brushing shoulders with Haryana. It is brushing shoulders with you know, these two cities, these two states, from where people do not think twice before coming and settling down here. Now, let us see, if you analyze the kind of people who migrate to this town, we find most of them come from the deprived strata of the society,
right,
where they come from the poorer sections of the society. When they come to Delhi, they land up here, they suddenly see there's so much of economic difference between the people, the haves and have-nots, as they say in economics, that it suddenly, you know, opens their eyes. And the craving, the deprivation, the feeling of deprivation, I think if you go into the mindset of a criminal, it is basically, I have been talking to a few people, you know, who, so I don't say I've been talking to criminals, but I've been talking to minds of the people who migrated in that town,
right,
you know, people who work for us. The general mentality is when they suddenly see a big house, a big car, the lifestyle of people here, they get carried away. It is that feeling of getting carried away which leads them to a crime.
Right.
And from petty street, they start with street crimes like robbery.
Sharad, they get carried away, and possibly there is also no deterrent to all these criminals and the crimes that are committed in the city. Let me also open Mr. Kakkar now. Mr. Kakkar, after 2012, especially the 16th of December, after the Nirbhaya case, one would at least expect that crime against women, you know, would cease or come down in terms of percentage. But if you look at the 2014 figures, crime against women, there were 15,265 cases reported. And just the next year, in 2016, that figure went up to more than 17,000. What is going on over here?
Before I take on your question, I would like to comment on what the previous speaker has said. I agree with him, the analysis that he has given. The migrants who come from, he's named three states, but the maximum migrants come to us from Bihar, from Orissa, then Haryana, UP, Eastern UP, etc., etc. Now, when they come here, obviously, they have no place to live. They just find some jhugi, something. So now you have to analyze the crime. Yes, the crime in Delhi is going up because of free registration, totally free registration. No crime here can really be go hidden, you know. So that is one issue. Very good. All crimes must be registered. Now, who are the people who are indulging into these crimes? The crimes are being indulged into people who... You just see 95% of the rapes committed in this city are by people who are known to the rapist. Okay, now what can you really do? And these are all, these 95%, of the 95%, let me tell you, 90% are committed in the colonies where the poorest of the poor live. Now, what do you expect the police to do? You do patrolling, you do all sorts of things, but it is unless the society wakes up to these crimes, the police alone will never be able to curb the social crime. I take rape as a social crime, and similarly harassment, etc., etc. Now, after the Nirbhaya case, it was expected, yes, the law was made more stringent, and it was expected that people will have an awe of the law, but nothing of that sort happened, because I'll tell you why. All these people who are now committing the crime and have been made accused, they hardly know about the change. They do not know that the law has really been made so stringent. And what have the really courts done? Have they really tried these cases on fast track basis? Tell me, which crime committed in 14, 15, 16 has seen the end today? So with all these factors coming into for the crime will increase when all people, 6 lakh people of whom around 5,90,000 are the poorest of the poor, they enter this city and settle down. This is annual. Annually, so many of them settle down. Now, you also made in your earlier review to say that Delhi has the maximum crime of all the UTs. Please, for God's sake, Delhi has a population of 1 crore 60 lakhs, and all other 6 UTs don't have population of even 25 lakhs. So let's not compare the uncomparable. You know, incomparable, where is the question of comparing these things? Delhi population is more, and then other territories, there are no migrants there, nothing of the sort, the old people live. Now,
okay.
Bear with me for
okay,
just
sir,
30
let's,
seconds
let's
more.
Also get, let's
see,
also
in
get
a village, in
initial
a village
reactions
in a town,
from Aishwarya Bhati, Supreme Court lawyer. Aishwarya,
people are known to each other, they hesitate to commit crime of this sort. But in Delhi, because nobody knows anybody.
Okay, sir, Mr. Kakkar, I'll come back to you. Sir, I'll come back to you. Let me also get, you know, a reaction from Aishwarya Bhatia. Aishwarya, crime in Delhi has been a nuisance for a lot of people, especially the women. You know, but after 2012, you know, there was a case which came into the limelight. There were a lot of protest against whatever happened, and everybody knows what transpired in 2012. The citizens of the capital at least expected that some sort of a deterrent would be floated, some sort of a deterrent would be established, and there would be fear of the law. But nothing has changed. Why?
The citizens.
Strongly maintained, and I believe that, you know, there is something that fundamentally wrong that we are doing. Now we must look at, see, change of laws is a step that is a reactionary step. We need to look at steps which are not reaction to incidents, but which are proactive. We have to go from finding cures to finding preventions. You know, we can't divorce the fact of this being a huge law and order issue. You know, if you look at it from the point of view of an accused, no accused thinks that, you know, how is this sentence prescribed or how is this punishment defined in the penal code and how I will be sentenced under it. Nobody thinks of that. The accused who is committing any particular crime only thinks that I will not be caught. And that is the only thing, that's the motivation that keeps him going. So that, you know, everything else that happens after the commission of the crime is something that is a reactionary thing. Law and order and policing is the most important aspects which are, you know, responsible for these things. Of course, it's very easy for us to say that till the time there is awareness in the society, these kind of crimes will continue. And I agree to some extent, you know, the crimes which are against women, they are in the category of hate crimes. So these are crimes which essentially need awareness from the society. But new laws per se will be able to achieve nothing, and these the records of the National Crime Bureau show that in our face. It's like staring in our face that new laws will make no difference till the time there is Aishwarya, actual difference.
Aishwarya, let me come back to you. Just hold on to that thought. What we'll do right now is try to figure out what the people of Delhi feel about crime in Delhi.
Mostly against women and old couples, they are attacked. And you keep reading every day in the newspaper, or seeing, watching on TV, you know.
Our Delhi police needs to take some high action to solve all these issues.
Child ka bhi hai, phir aapka women's ka hai, aur robbery bhi hai. Robbery abhi apni jagah jo continue chaldi rehti hai, robbery bhi. Main cheeze ye hai ki samne cheeze nahi aa pati puri tarike se.
I believe all kinds of crimes are on a rise in Delhi, especially against women and children.
सब में चल रहा है, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है कि रॉबरी में कम है या फिर सीनियर सिटीजन के लिए कम है या फिर चाइल्ड्स के लिए कम है, सब में है.
Okay, that's one topic that citizens of this city are, you know, familiar with. They know the nuances of and the nuisance of, you know, the crime that happens in the city. And Sharad, it is also, you know, understood that the police is also partly responsible for being a little callous when it comes to registering complaints and reacting to some of these crimes. It's their casual approach which has also caused these figures to go up.
Yes, absolutely, because if we see the crime solving rate, in fact, we would like to get in Mr. Kakkar after this, the crime solving rate of the Delhi police for the year 2015 was 27%, which means one out of four approximate crimes were solved. So if we, again, going back to what I said, if you go into the mindset of the criminal, if there are four criminals, or let's say three criminals and one non-criminal sitting together and trying to instigate the fourth one, he'll say, kar do yaar, dekha jayega, yahan kuch nahi hota hai. Kuch nahi hota yaar.
There is no deterrent.
There is no deterrent. So because of absence of deterrent, because of the low case solving ratio, that is one aspect. Second aspect which I wanted to bring, the second deterrent, which is one stage ahead, Vineet, which is the way judiciary deals with the cases. If we go into the statistics, more than 1 million criminal cases are pending in 24 high courts in the country.
Hmm.
Supreme Court alone has got about 59,000, more than 59,000 cases pending. So that is the second stage of one deterrent is the police solving the case.
Right.
Second deterrent, even if police solves the case and he's brought to the books, the case just lingers on and on in the court. And that is another thing which instigates the criminal. कि कुछ नहीं यार दो चार साल क्या बात है जेल में काटेंगे उसके बाद we'll be out we'll be free again.
So in a sense what you're saying is, and you know Aishwarya Bhatti should also respond to this, that if the police swiftly solves the case, the courts will make sure that the case takes a long time to reach its logical conclusion.
Absolutely, it's the casual approach.
It's the casual approach of these two departments that actually fuels the fire of crime in the NCR.
Absolutely, I agree. There can be no denying that, Vineet, but I'm drawing your attention to the stage prior to commission of the crime. See, in our system, if you have to lodge an FIR of a missing girl, then, missing girl report will take you, if you are sitting in a police station, it will take you all day to lodge that report. And, these are things that the reactionary time should be within 2, 3, 4, 5 minutes. No, if you wait the whole day to write the report, then whatever bad has to happen with that girl would have happened. So here I'm talking about, the fear of law enforcement. There is, of course, I'm not running away from the fact that investigation takes forever and the judiciary takes forever. But those are all stages of cure. We have to go ahead. The stage of prevention has to be very emphatically looked in. I was just making a comparison. Recently, there was a comparison between the amounts that is, amount of money that is spent in providing facilities to Olympians at the time of preparation and the money that is given to them after they have won the medals, etc. So, please, you saw recently that comparison was made. Just 30-40 lakh of rupees was spent on PV Sidhu when she needed it the most. And when she won the medal, some, 20-25 crores were given to her. So we have to look at the stage before. So that stage before has to be from effective policing, effective law and order. Otherwise, the real difference on the ground will not happen. I strongly believe that.
So prevention is better than cure. And, if we go through these stats, Mr. Kakkar, I want to draw your attention to this. Crime against women is probably one area, where the percentage has gone up a lot high. And it also is, a big chunk of the 173,000 odd cases which were registered in Delhi. But second on the list is complaints against police for corruption and for not cooperating, and in fact at times exploiting the situation and conniving with the criminals and making cases disappear is one other area which is probably something that you should reflect on. You've been in the system, you've seen the system, you've seen the nuances. Tell us, sir, these cases against police, what is the main reason behind this?
Which one you want me to answer first? Okay. Now, let me tell you that crime definitely is on the increase, and it will increase with increase in population, increase in unemployment, etc., etc. Like anything, any other thing, the crime will also increase. Very good. Now, what happens is that in the West, we do not have enough investigating officers to invest, because somebody said 27% only are solved. Now, we do not have enough investigating officers with us. See, we will have to change the total pattern of crime registration and solving. I know in Western countries, in America, etc., a vehicle theft, unless it is connected to a sort of other crime, a vehicle theft is just not registered, because then you have the insurance go and take money from the insurance. Look how many vehicle thefts are there among these cases that are there in Delhi. Similarly, if a theft is less than probably $10,000, then it is again go to the insurance. Now here, even if a bicycle is stolen, literally speaking, an FIR must be registered. Okay. Now we'll have to change this pattern, and I request the our judiciary to go into it, and also the bureaucracy. Please change the that archaic law of 1861. Give us the fewer cases which need to be solved, so that the present available investigating agencies can really solve. Now coming to the corruption thing, you see, this is one of those things which is unending. Everybody is when we say everybody is corrupt or everybody is not corrupt. Take any profession, anybody who finds a sort of loophole, he will make some money. Maybe police also does, and everybody, the lawyers do the same, and the bureaucracy does the same, the corporation people do the same. But we always pinpoint the police good thing. Maybe you say that the police, but everybody, every government servant in this country, given an opportunity, barring a few, will make money. So let's just not single out the police. What I'm saying is, increase the investigating officers, reduce the burden of investigation on the investigating officers by making few changes. Let the insurance companies take over. After all, you are paying them, and when the theft takes place, even now what happened? You register an FIR. After 30 days, if the vehicle is not detected, then you go to the agency and claim whatever is the claim that you have. Then why go into this process of vehicle theft? Unless the vehicle theft is connected to another crime, like murder, like, you know, robbery, like something else. That is all that is done. So Let's change the pattern.
Let's change the pattern.
I hope people are listening.
Speaking
people
of patterns,
who better, they
Sharad
are listening.
Coming
that,
to you,
let's
you
change
know,
this.
According to a recent survey, and you know, since Mr. Kakkar mentioned patents, there is a trend in which people are actually leaving. There's been an exodus of people who are going out of Delhi because of the increasing crime, number one, and number two, because of the pollution. And a lot of things have been said about the tussle between the center and the state as to who's going to control the police. If the state has some leeway, some sort of, you know, control over the police, things might be different. Are you of this view? Do you concur with this view that if the state has some control, you know, a certain percentage of all the police in Delhi is allotted to the state, there could be a difference in the crimes?
Well, you talked about certain percentage. So if there's division between the two, I really don't think that will help. Mm. Now, if we say that if you hand it over to the state, you hand it over to a state government, the police, like other states, which Delhi doesn't have, you know, then we are pointing out to the center, which means the center, the home ministry, which directly monitors the police. This means there's something wrong with the home ministry's monitoring. So instead of blaming the controlling authority, let's not forget, police is police. Whether it's controlled by the state government, whether it is controlled by the central government, police cannot shirk away their responsibility. I take a very simple example. Okay. Somebody goes to report a case in, let's say, Malviya Nagar, and the case has happened in South Extension. Right. He said, sir, you go and report your case to South Extension because ye hamara jurisdiction nahi hai. In the process, you wasted a few hours. By that time, criminal is at large.
Sharad, let me come back to you. Joining us is Nitin Tyagi of the Aam Aadmi Party and Ashish Sood, the General Secretary of the BJP. Nitin Tyagi, your government is in power in Delhi. You know, the crimes in Delhi don't seem to cease. The reports are very disturbing. The citizens are concerned. You know, today is a day where waterlogging is being discussed. And, you know, your party is also bearing the brunt of waterlogging all over Delhi. But today we are talking about crime. What do you have to say about this recent report about crimes going, you know, out of control in Delhi?
Absolutely. Even we are extremely concerned and bothered about the level of crime that is reaching in Delhi. And see, we have a very simple view to it. Just because there's a big dilemma who the police is reporting to. In fact, even the police is quite unhappy with the state of affairs. They are asking for 15,000 more personnel. They are asking for more budget for cameras and other equipment, which the central government has refused. We have been trying to pursue the central government also to help the police augment their force over here in Delhi, but that's not seem to be happening. They're just not bothered about it. Scene center is just not bothered. And if they're reporting to the Home Minister, I don't know how much time the Home Minister or the PMO has for Delhi being a very small state, although it's extremely important. I don't know how much of importance that the center give to Delhi as far as the police is concerned. And police just seem to be more conscious
Nitin,
about
hold
the
on
fact
to that
what
thought.
They
let
are
me
doing,
also open. We don't have much time
VIPs
on the show. Nitin, hold on to that
with
thought. Mr. Ashish Sood, you know, I don't want to be statistically poetic. But according to this report, one out of four crimes in this country is committed in Delhi. And the tussle and the tug of war between the center and state is not helping anyone. Your thoughts, sir?
Yes, it is not helping any of the citizens of Delhi, but it may be helping the political ambitions of the Aam Aadmi Party and its mentor, Mr. Arvind Kejriwal. Because a non-performing government can only find a, will always try to find a scapegoat on who's to or on whom they should blame the all the failures and all mishappenings in Delhi. I was listening to Mr. Tyagi when Mr. Tyagi was saying the central government has refused the money and all those blah blah things. Before answering to all those things, I would like to ask Mr. Tyagi whether he has any official
wanted or the 408 crores that they wanted, they wanted for the cameras
where,
and other security
they
equipment
to,
they have been refused
where they wanted to control the Delhi police, where they had suggested some serious suggestions.
No, absolutely, we say give us Delhi police.
You
let us take decisions. Let Delhi police be accountable to us.
They will not be
we
able
will ensure,
to present
we
any
will
document.
Ensure. See, we want to
no,
work. We want to work
when,
along with Delhi police
were
for the betterment of the people,
Dixit,
for the welfare of
when
the people.
You
but if it
using
is, would
Dixit,
be like
see,
Delhi police
against
the Aam Aadmi Party or its workers or its MLAs?
How many CCTVs have you installed in Delhi?
The focus is
not
there.
It should be accountable to you. When you presented 70-point agenda to the people of Delhi, didn't you know that Delhi police is not responsible to the people of to the government of city?
Absolutely, we knew about it, but we did not know the intentions of the center that they will not allow any of the Delhi police or any of their agencies or the LG to cooperate with Delhi. We did not suspect that you had such
Delhi police
intentions.
Then you cry about LG.
We did not expect the center to have such malafide intentions towards
the
people of Delhi who did not vote for the BJP, who just...
Okay.
You know, shrunk them to just three seats in Delhi.
Will you
did not know the malafide intention
question?
Behind
can
all this.
You,
that,
okay, gentlemen, we're running out of time.
You people poll
you
as if we did not know. We knew it. But the problem is, we did not know
okay.
about your intention.
Ashish
about,
and Nitin,
and your plans
we'll reserve the contents
of
your debate for another day. I am sorry to say we have run out of time. I would like to thank in this point in time to all our guests for joining us and sharing their thoughts. Keep watching News World India, and we'll be back with current issues tomorrow. Thank you.